Hi, I'm Chris Jarman from Eliminator Kustoms here in Goodrich, Michigan. We kind of specialize in high-end race cars, street car, metal fabrication, and engines. Today I want to talk to you a little bit about the proper techniques and procedures on welding mild steel roll cages in cars. A lot of times we get people that try to do it their own or shops that are unqualified, which is great, but they don't pass certification. And a lot of these cars have to pass certifications. So what we're going to talk about is different angles that you will find in these race cars that you need the proper technique to get the proper weld techniques down. We're going to go over some joints that we recently cut out of a customer's car that would not pass certifications. I'd like to point out some of the flaws in the welding process here. Here you can see the weld is very cold. The fusion is not, in some spots, etching into the metal on both sides. On this joint, you actually have a lot of stop and starts, and you can actually tell the way the weld looks that there was a huge gap that the person tried to fill in, which is something you really don't want. What you're really trying to achieve is a perfect weld like this. Great fusion on both sides. We had good tight joint preparation, which aids in the welding process to get to this finished product. For our project today, we've chosen the Millermatic 212 Auto-Set. We're going to be using this to weld 134 wall DOM roll cage tubing mild steel. We're choosing to use the machine in manual mode because we're going to be making fine adjustments to our weld and wire speed due to the angles and notches typically found in the roll cage application we're going to be doing. We're going to be using 030 wire. We're going to be using a 7525 argon CO2 mix also in the process. Okay, the first joint we're going to go over today with our tips is the 90 degree joint. First you want to make sure that you have a really good fit. This is going to lead to a good weld joint. The next thing you want to do is make sure you tack in good four spots, okay? Usually you can typically go top and bottom, side to side. If you do that, you'll actually probably, depending on your weld style, will actually, when you're welding, you'll weld over top of your tack. We like to weld and actually tack in the four corners. That way we can actually start and stop at our four tacks. Okay, we're going to talk to you a little bit about tip about welding direction. On this joint actually is thicker tubing. We actually use the pull method, which is actually pulling the gun towards us, the MIG gun. What that's doing is it's actually creating more penetration due to the weld wire actually going towards the heat at all time. If you're going to be using thinner metal, what you might want to do is try the push method, because what you are doing, the wire is actually transferring towards the cooler part of the joint, which is creating less heat for less penetration, which will give you more control and not as much of a chance to actually blow a hole through your weld. Okay, the next joint we're going to talk about is our 30 degree joint. We've already got it tacked up. We chose to tack it on each side and on the bottom in 3 points. The reason we're going to do that is we're going to actually start in the deepest part of the bevel. We're going to go down one side, we're going to come down the other side, and then we're going to finish weld the bottom up. Okay, we finished up our 30 degree joint. During the process, the gun nozzle was able to get down deep enough in the joint to actually permit us not changing the settings on the machine. During this process, we actually used a push method so we could actually watch the arc and the puddle as we were actually doing the weld. Okay, we're going to go on to our last joint here, which is our 45 degree. You can tell the joint is much deeper. We've gone ahead and tacked it up. The one thing I want to show you is a little tip. We are going to be adjusting the machine now. We're going to be turning it up just a little bit, the heat. Reason being is, the wire is sticking out of the nozzle a little bit farther because we cannot get the MIG gun tip down in the joint as far as such on a 30 degree angle. What happens is we are going to turn up the machine to promote the wire burning off hotter in this joint because it's sticking out longer so we can get better penetration in the weld. Today we showed you a lot of typical joints that you're going to find on common roll cage construction. One of the highlights that we pointed out was your actual MIG gun nozzle placement in the joint as you're welding. Another good tip to remember is, depending on your material thickness, whether you want to use the pull or drag method or the push away from you method. The drag method towards you will promote more penetration and more heat for thicker metals. If you're trying to weld thinner metals, you might want to try the push method because it directs the heat away from the weld with less penetration to prevent you from blowing through your material for getting the weld too hot. For more racing, customizing, and restoring tips, go to MillerWelds.com.